The answer.
I have to go to the meeting.
You promised me you'd let this be.
It's my duty to fight for my country.
Your duty is to your wife, to your children.
I'm fighting for my wife.
The answer. The answer.
And violence.
We came here to voice our grievances, and we were met with muskets of contempt.
Which party does that make intent on violence?
Oh, we have heard your so-called demands. Now you must hear ours. The crowd will disperse immediately.
We did not come here to leave before achieving anything. You've heard our answers. We'll await yours.
Mr. Jenkins, do whatever is necessary.
Thank you.
man. He is steadily building his own kingdom, a kingdom of darkness, a kingdom that is built on the rebellion against the authority established by God. Search every inch. These fugitive traitors will not escape the wrath of the law.
Thank you. to lie down here?
Is he a mask or a rat?
What?
Because all we have down here is mice and rats. Oh, well, if he's a mask, they get eaten by the rats. If he's a rat, well, we kill the rats.
That's yeah. Enough. I want to see my husband.
Ooh, and I want to know the Queen of Spain.
There's more chance of that happening than you seeing any prisoners.
He's been sentenced to death. What harm can come from you seeing him?
It matters not then. If you see him, or do not see him, he'll be just as dead.
And the Reverend Morgan Howells, can you at least tell me whether he's alive or dead?
The Reverend Howells is alive. You are his wife?
Yes, Elizabeth Howells.
You may see him.
And what of my husband, Lewis Lewis?
No visitors.
He is going to be hanged. Have you no compassion at all to Lancy's wife one last time?
A convicted revolutionary deserves no compassion.
Definitely a rat, I think.
Yeah. And what about this one?
Well, she's been here all day, not said a word. But I think she may be a traitor. Richard Lewis is one.
My husband is not a traitor.
There are witnesses.
Richard did not stab anyone.
I am confident his guilt will be clearly established at his trial.
I don't doubt you know a great deal about guilt.
Leave us. I did not give you permission to leave.
Do not touch me.
I have always admired you.
To see my husband?
You've hardly changed. I knew it was you as soon as I saw
you. I want to see my husband.
Prisoners are not allowed visitors before trial. But I have a considerable influence with the prison governor.
Prison governor?
I can help you see your husband. You just have to do as I say.
Never touch me again.
You can pretend all you want, but you know that you will always belong to me.
I belong to myself and no one else.
You would do well to remember who I am.
Oh, I remember who you are. And I remember what you've done. There is nothing you can threaten me with. You have taken everything from me already.
Don't! Your husband has brought this on himself.
I am not talking about my husband. And he wasn't a bully or a coward like his father!
You shut up now! If you know what's good for you, and you don't want to end up like your husband, you'll shut your mouth!
Tell me to shut up! Threaten to kill me! It won't do anything! The doll you took died, and you can't take what's already dead!
Get out! Now!
When you've had all the women, and you killed the fathers and the babies, what will you do then? Look at you, all dressed up like this big, strong man. What's the matter?
I am the law, and I demand respect.
You are a monster. My husband dies because he had the courage to fight you. He dies a free man. Richard is twice the man you will ever be.
Free. Your husband is a thug, rotting in a jail cell, awaiting an execution he very much deserves.
You don't get it, do you? You think that your uniform and your gun give you power, but you're wrong. My husband, I die soon. This was never the story of one man. There will always be someone else ready to fight. We are done being told how to live. We are done being used by men like you.
I know you. Don't pretend you didn't enjoy it.
You have taken everything from me already. You owe me this. You owe me one last time with Richard before you take it from me too.
Jayla!
Take this woman to see the prisoner.
My brother.
Your brother?
Richard Lewis. Another innocent man you've incarcerated within these walls.
You are sister to the evil revolutionary who almost killed a soldier of the crown.
Richard is not a man of murdering his father.
And you defend this thug. Perhaps I was wrong to consider you an innocent party. I will not release a guilty man.
No, Morgan is truly innocent.
But you say that Richard Lewis is innocent too. And that is a man who's been condemned by the mouths of honest witnesses. And now you expect me to believe your denial of your husband's guilt.
My husband does not share any of my brother's guilt.
Are you now saying that Richard Lewis is guilty?
His guilt is forgotten,
sorry. No, Richard must not be condemned to save you.
He is condemned anyway. And I will not lose you.
Go, both of you.
And Richard?
He is to stand before court tomorrow. No doubt he'll be sentenced to suffer the hangman's noose as he deserves.
Richard Lewis is charged on the 3rd day of June in the year of our Lord, 1831. You did, with malicious intent, conspire and incite riot, contrary to the Riot Act of 1814, and did attempt
until you are dead.
Your mother refused to give me a sentence. Richard will hang next week.
Harry, wait!
It is not your fault that Richard will be hanged.
Before the cock crows.
Whatever you had said, Jenkins would never have let Richard free. The English wolves need a sacrificial lamb.
So why do I still feel that I betrayed my brother?
Because you are a good woman, Elizabeth.
He held me in his arms when I was a baby. He grew up always looking out for me. Yet when Jenkins asked, I could not defend him and excuse him the better.
Thank you. Thank you.
How did we come to this, Josiah?
There will always be troublemakers. They come, they go. We are constant.
So it's business as usual, then?
Of course. An example has been made to discourage any further dissent. So that's an end to it.
Is it? Is it really?
Thank you. camera. Begin to be like, everything just blew out.
Thank you.